Welcome back to another episode of Smile Mah Podcast. I'm your host, Hafdeezy, and you already know that we're your go-to for entertainment news, music industry updates, and everything else in between. Now, we got to talk about the shocking story that's making waves right now, and it's about Lil Durk, the feds, and how some of his song lyrics could possibly be used against him right now in his criminal case. So buckle up, shit's about to get real. First off, let's set the stage. Lil Durk is one of the biggest names in hip-hop right now, and he's facing some heavy allegations. Just 2 weeks ago, Durk was arrested on conspiracy to commit murder for hire charges, and now the feds are piling on with a new indictment of accusing him of ordering his OTF crew to take out Quando Rondo in Los Angeles back in 2022. But here's where it gets wild. Prosecutors are claiming that Durk not only ordered the hit, but turned around and commercialized it by rapping about the revenge in his song. They're quoting lyrics from his track Wonderful Wayne and Jackie Boy, where Durk allegedly references a new clip tied to the attack. Check this out.
They ass gonna hurt you though. Tell me they got an addy. Go. Got location. Go. Green light. Go. 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 Look on the news and see your son.
Crazy, right? Now let that sink in for a minute. Now let's talk about the bigger issue here, the use of rap lyrics as evidence in court. Now, this isn't the first time that we've seen this, and remember Young Thug? His lyrics were a major part of his recent criminal case. Critics argue that the practice is unfair, and it unfairly targets black artists and violates free speech. Lawmakers in the music industry have been trying to fight back, but cases like these keep happening. The question is, should song lyrics be treated as literal confessions, or are they just creative storytelling? Let me know what y'all think in the comments below, or hit me up on social media and let me know. Now let's be real, these charges are no joke. The feds are saying OTF isn't just a music label, but a criminal organization acting on Durk's orders. If convicted, Durk could be looking at life in prison. Now, it doesn't stop with him. Prosecutors are also going after several alleged OTF members and others tied to the case. They claim that this was all retaliation for the killing of King Von, one of Durk's closest friends, back in 2020. Now, this story is far from over, and you already know that I'm gonna keep you updated right here on Smile Mah Podcast. Now that's it for today's episode, and it's definitely a crazy time in the music world right now, and stories like these remind us how art and reality can collide in an unexpected and sometimes tragic way. But don't forget to like, comment, share, subscribe, hit the notification bell, and share this episode with your friends, and let's get the conversation going. Is it fair game, or are the feds stepping out of bounds? And shout out to all my listeners, stay safe, stay inspired, keep smiling, and I'll catch y'all in the next one. Peace.